The following video will outline a safe procedure for the use of suction to assist in the clearing of a patient's airway. This video is designed to be used by student nurses in conjunction with a practical learning session and directed reading, and therefore is not inclusive of all you need to know before competently performing this skill in practice. And always refer and adhere to local policy in the area you're working when performing suction techniques. Hi Bob, I'm Graham, one of the nurses. I'm going to try and help you clear some of these secretions and help you cough by using some suction in your airway. So we've got here a suction control device and a receptacle for any secretions. We can switch this on now, and we're aiming to keep a suction pressure between 100 and 150 millimetres of mercury. We've got a range of flexible suction catheters, ranging from about a size 6 up to a size 18 French gauge. These have the benefit of being flexible and allow us to pass into a patient's mouth, even if the teeth are closed. So we can use some water-soluble lubricant if necessary. We can gently introduce the catheter down into the sides of the mouth, and we're going to apply suction on the way back out, noting what we're removing from the patient's airway. The other option with these, because they're soft and flexible, is that we can pass it through the nose and into the nasopharynx, encourage the patient to cough. So in this instance, Bob, I'm going to pass this suction catheter into your nose. It might be a little bit uncomfortable. If it becomes very distressing, I will stop. So I'm just gently going to advance that into your nose, about a third of the length of the catheter, or until I stimulate a cough, and then suction on the way back, noting what is coming up out of the airway. I'm trying to do that within about 10 seconds to try and prevent any discomfort for the patient or cause any further hypoxia. So if repeated attempts at nasopharyngeal suctioning are required, it may be less distressing for the patient to have a nasopharyngeal airway passed. They come in a variety of different types, some with a retainer pin and others with a wide flange to prevent inhalation. Sizing, a size 6 for a female or a small man, a size 7 for a large lady or most men. Again, they need to be lubricated with a water-soluble lubricant. The nostril should be identified as being the clearest nostril available. If there's any other device, we'll obviously have to go to the other side. We gently insert the airway into the nostril, moving the tube up into a more upright position, horizontal position, and gently advancing. If you're having to put a lot of pressure, stop. Small amount of blood streaking is normal. Heavy bleeding is a problem. You need to get help. And we now have a track down which I can pass the suction catheter and help the patient to cough. There you go, Bob. You can cough that up for me. Again, applying the suction pressure only on the way out of the nostril.
Hazards associated with nasopharyngeal suction include risk of deoxygenation through interruption of oxygen supply, the potential for vagal stimulation producing bradycardia, potential to stimulate a gag reflex, vomiting through inadvertent placement of suction catheter into the esophagus, and trauma and bleeding.
Bob, we're going to help clear some of those secretions from your mouth. I'm going to use a different kind of suction catheter this time. Our other option is a rigid suction catheter, useful for moving a lot of highly viscous material from a patient's airway. However, the rigidity of the catheter does mean there's a higher risk of doing harm, so we'll exercise a bit more caution by keeping the tip of the catheter where I can see it at all times. Bob, I'm going to help you clear those secretions now. So gently passing the catheter into the cheek pouch and applying the suction pressure is now on at all times, coming back out across the tongue and down into the other cheek pouch, making sure I can see where the tip of the catheter is at all times. Avoid going over the midline, as you'll make the patient gag, and again keeping a suction sweep down to about 10 seconds. Unlike the previous catheter, we can reuse this one for a few attempts, probably up to about 24 hours, whereas the others are single use, and we'll just clean it through with some water. A few key points in terms of general care in suctioning a patient's airways. Remember that positioning may be useful for airway clearing manoeuvres. Suction should be applied for no longer than 10 seconds to minimise the risk of deoxygenation. If appropriate, give oxygen before and after a suctioning attempt. The patient may have an intact gag reflex that we may stimulate by our suction attempt, in which case we should abandon. And remember to keep the suction pressure between 100 to 150 millimetres of mercury. And thicker secretions may require repeated attempts with appropriate rest periods for the patient, or use of a wider bore catheter before adjusting the suction pressure upwards.